Welcome to another video where we're going to be talking about how you can make money dropshipping on Shopify. Now we're going to break it down to you and make it as easy as possible for you to understand. So without further ado, let's see how beginners can make money dropshipping from the very first day. Okay, so first things first, if you're a beginner and don't or even do know about dropshipping, it would be helpful if we tell you a little more about it. So dropshipping is basically a method of selling products on retail where a store doesn't actually have the products it sells stocked up. This may be intriguing as how you can sell something that you don't even have. Well, it's simple. Through dropshipping, you ship products that your customers buy from you directly from the wholesaler to their address. This way, the seller doesn't need to handle the product themselves. And when it comes to the biggest difference between dropshipping and the normal retail method, it is the fact that you, the seller, don't own stock or inventory, but instead you purchase the inventory as you need from a wholesaler or manufacturers and then fulfill the orders that you get. So we think that pretty much clears it all up, and now that it's out of the way, let's jump right into our first step. Step 1. Find a niche. The number one reason most dropshipping businesses fail is that they try to include lots of products in dozens of categories. More products doesn't necessarily mean more sales. Instead, you should try to find a niche and include a collection of the best products on your Shopify store. This will make things easier for you to manage and promote your products more easily. To find a profitable niche, go to AliExpress and search for a product category. Then you could just look for the best-selling niches in that category. Remember that by this point, you haven't chosen the particular products that you're going to be selling. In fact, you're just looking for the particular type of products that you're going to be dealing with. And anything could be your niche, be it sports, or shoes, or handbags, or even car accessories. Step 2. Reach out to influencers. Though you may be wondering that this step should have come much later because at this point you don't even have a store to begin with, but it's actually very helpful if you reach out to influencers before you create a store. This way you save yourself from situations like you creating a store and showing different products, but then finding out that there is no market for it and nobody even wants to buy it. Oh, the horror! So, approaching influencers as a start will actually prevent that, and also help you get a better idea about the kind of promotion that is out there waiting for you. Also, this gives you the time to see which influencer is the best for your niche and will really give you that needed boost, and if they're even reachable. So how can you find a good influencer is by figuring out their engagement level. And what you can do to find that out is by going to a website called tanky.fr and going to its engagement calculator. This calculator lets you input the usernames of Instagram influencers and then tells you the engagement that they get once you submit it. So if you, for example, put in Kylie Jenner's Instagram, it'll show you her exact number of followers, how many posts she has, the average number of likes that she gets per post, the average comments, and most importantly, the engagement rate. This is a measure of how many likes and comments Kylie gets on her post as a percentage of her number of followers. So a trick for filtering out the best influencer is by looking for a more than 3% engagement rate. 3% is the absolute minimum, and this is especially true of smaller influencers, and you really need to keep an eye out for that engagement rate. And since it's obvious that you won't be going for huge influencers as a beginner, you want to go for micro influencers. And in order to find the best influencers for your niche, what you can do is just go on Instagram and type in your niche in the search bar as a hashtag. So if your niche is makeup, type in hashtag makeup, and then you'll find some pages that are relevant to your niche. You can just go through these pages and see their following and also calculate their engagement rates. You can also see any other shoutouts that they've done on their pages to see what the comments and likes look like, and if the influencer is worth your time. So once you have figured out the best influencers that can help you make money really quickly, you can start reaching out to them. They'll tell you their rates, what kind of promotion they can do, etc., etc., and then you can see if you could afford them or not. Step 3. Set up the store. Okay, so now that you have negotiated with your influencers, it's time to start setting up your store. You'll have to start off by signing up to Shopify first. And we don't know if you know this already, but Shopify costs you $29 per month, and once you finish your free trial, a period of 14 days. And that is 2 whole weeks for free, which gives you more than enough time to really get comfortable with the platform and really test things out. You can sign up to Shopify using the link in the description box below. So once you are done with the sign up process, you should be able to log in to your Shopify account dashboard. This is where you'll be setting up and managing your dropship store. The dashboard may look empty at the moment, as you can see here, but once your store is up and running, it will show you analytics, orders, sales, and a lot more info about your store that will be helpful. You'll notice that Shopify has already set up the store for you, and there is very little work that you have to actually do to customize the way you like, and we're going to tell you all about that too. First, what you have to do is head over to the settings page. Now, we know it can be overwhelming to see all these options and tabs on this page, and Shopify has already configured most of the settings, and you don't have to change them unless you want to. And here are a couple of things that you should customize. Go to General Options and change the currency to USD or whichever currency you want to make transactions in. Then go to Payment Providers and choose how customers can pay during the checkout. You can allow your customers to pay with more different options, including PayPal, credit cards, Skrill, Stripe, and many more. And this one's a bonus. To make your store look more professional, you should install a Shopify store theme. You can either browse a collection of free themes or buy a premium theme from the Shopify theme store. So this way, using a premium theme will make your shop look more professional. For now, just to show you guys, we're using a free theme. And lastly, before you add products to your store, you need to create collections. Collections are like categories for your products. It helps you to organize your products properly and arrange your products on your store homepage. For example, if you're selling shoes, you should have shoes in different styles, like boots and sneakers, right there on the homepage for your customers to buy. However, if you don't even go to do all that yourself, you could just outsource it, meaning you could get someone else to set up your store for you and pay them for it. They may even be much better than you as a beginner, and you could really benefit off of their skills. Step 4, find a product. So this is another most important step of this whole process, and this is where you'll actually be finding the products that you'll sell on your store. You already have your niche in mind, so now begins the search for the best products. So one of the most common options for doing this is AliExpress, where you can buy stuff from wholesalers, as AliExpress supports businesses that sell through dropship stores. But another easier way is through a site called Oberloo. By using Oberloo, you'll still be seeing all of the products on AliExpress, but you'll be able to import them directly from AliExpress and onto your Shopify store. And you know the best thing? It's absolutely free. You could just download the Oberloo app in your Shopify. Shopify is going to ask you to sign in again, and you'd be able to integrate the two apps together. Oberloo will let you import the products that you want, and then once a customer buys it, you can simply go on AliExpress and ship it to their address. Step 5, go live. So now that you've imported products, set up the store and everything, you could finally launch your store for the public. You'll be able to do this once you agree to a paid plan by Shopify, and once you've done that, you can now start making money. So that's it for today. We really hope you liked it, and if you did, don't forget to leave a like. Also, subscribe to our channel where we will be releasing interesting content. Till next time, goodbye.